Welcome to rygurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about component testing. Generally, component testing will be performed after unit testing, and every component of any particular project will be verified separately without integrations. So this is a very important part of software testing. So we'll discuss here in detail what is component testing, what are objectives of component testing, their techniques, process of component testing, why unit testing versus component testing, and why component testing will be required, and what all advantages of component testing. And throughout this complete process, I will explain you by using example. If you think so, you want to learn about complete detail about component testing, so please be available from start to end of this video. And if you want to start your journey in software testing, then follow my complete playlist of software testing. Now, what is component testing? As I said, component testing is a subcategory of software testing in which individual components of the software is separately tested without integrating with other components. So let's consider an example here. If we are testing on WhatsApp application, WhatsApp applications is having 5 major components. So all 5 major components testing will be done separately without integrations. So whenever the tester will receive any particular wheel, that will have one major functionality. So let's consider the example of all 5 components of the WhatsApp application. One is Messenger, second is audio calling, third is video calling, fourth is settings, and fifth is payment. So in that case, every time tester will receive one functionality. It means, let's consider version 1 contains only Messenger, version 2 contains only settings, version 3 contains only audio settings or audio components, and version 4 contains video component, and fifth will be payment gateway. So every time tester will test each and every components unless and until that components will be perfect or bug free. So these are called as individual testing without integrations. It is also known as module testing when viewed from an architecture perspective. Component testing requires a test strategy and test plan where we consider each part of the software individually. So what all objectives of component testing will be? So to reduce the risk. So generally, after integration, we might have the risk of validations each component of the software and helps to identify bugs in software code and fix them. So generally, if the developer will integrate all the codes together, the risk of getting or the risk of mixing everything is more. So in that case, the developer is building one component and sharing that component with the tester to verify it. If all goes well, then they are integrating. And sometimes what happens, the team or development team are into different components working separately. So let's say if in any organizations we have total 10 developers, so it might be happen that 4 of them are working in one component and rest 6 of them are working in another component. So in that case, parallelly they are building 2 functionality together. So generally, these type of component without integrating, they are giving to the testing team to verify it. If all working fine, then they will integrate both the functionality. So risk will reduce here. Second is to improve quality of the components. Component testing is essential in developing and maintaining confidence in the components. Fewer bugs in additional testing, thus improving the quality of the software. So if the first components will be good and quality of code will be good, then only they are integrating with the second components. Validating the functional and non-functional components is again an objective of doing component testing, where every functional and non-functional components can be tested, like their functionality, the behavior, flows, navigation, images, UI testing, everything will be tested, their performance, then they are integrating with the other components. Fourth is discover bugs in the components. So Every component is having the different coding structure because the different developers have been built. So in that case, the tester is verifying or discovering the defects in components, and once the defect will be fixed, everything is fine, then only they are integrating with other components to prevent the bugs is again a major objective of component testing. Now, which all techniques of component testing we have? First is CTIS and second is CTIL. That means component testing in small and component testing in large. So when we talk about component testing, can be executed with or without separating software components. When the testing is performed by isolating other components, it is known as CTIS. And when the component is performed by isolating other component is called as CTIL. So let's consider we have three components, component X, Y, and Z. Verifying each components in detail and related to the navigations all is called as CTIL, that is component testing in large. So let's take one example here. So if you can see this rygurukul.com website, here we have menu sections. If I'm just verifying these all menus, like we have 3, 6, 7, and 8 menu sections we have. We are just verifying only these menu titles. It means we are doing CTIS, that is component testing in small. If we are doing testing for all this sub menu as well, then we are performing or doing the testing on large, that is CTIL, component testing in large. So generally we are taking example of menu options here. If I'm verifying these 8 tiles in detail, so 8 tiles in details, I'm not going inside this four courses of each components. So I'm just verifying these 8 tiles. So that is called as component testing in small. Again, if I'm going inside this every sections and verifying, instead of just verifying this 8 tiles, I'm also verifying this courses as well, these individual courses as well, it means I am doing CTIL. So this is the difference between CTIS and CTIL and how we will perform it. Next is, what is the difference between unit testing versus component testing? So generally, unit testing will be performed by the developer based on that individual program modules to verify that they execute as per the specifications. But component testing will be performed by the testing team with or without isolating other components. Unit testing validates design documents, but component testing validate test requirement and use cases, and unit testing is performed first and component testing is performed after unit testing, so that we can verify every component thoroughly. Now, why is component testing is important? So here, while doing component testing, the testers verify detailed evaluations of any functionality or product. Each individual components enables the detailed evaluation after all the components we have been acquired. We can test for all the possible bugs on real web server. The same is not possible for unit testing. We are not test each unit on live server. Second is early bug identifications. Component testing can be executed at any stage to verify the component is working fine or not. Generally, right now, organizations adopted agile methodology. In that case, every component's tested in early phases so that we can find the defect early stage and fix that bug sooner, so that we can save the cost and money of rework and effort and time. It also enables the developing team to test the software components for all the preventable bugs or defects before handling it over to the QA team. Next is certified contracts. Component testing helps us to certify the contract. Component testing is reliable. It is the best possible way to validate our module or component to deliver the software as specified. Also, software can be integrated without any doubt. So this is all about component testing. Hope you enjoyed this content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.